One story, An Intimate Stranger by Brighton Breitenbach, is about the origin of writing. Ancient Chinese lore has it that writing evolved from magical signs, from runes and the symbols or depictions of the bones cast by diviners. On the day, humans begin to codify the signs and their meanings by repeating them at will, without the help of diviners. They begin, in effect, to trace the openings to the unknown. Gods and demons wept because now there was no longer heaven and earth. Humans had interjected themselves between reality and dream. Now there was a go-between straddling the known and the unknowable. Something autonomous had come into being.
Thank you.
walking on the Lakota Okene Road, I see men with shovels and hoes waiting. Only 7 in the morning. They dally beside the road. What draws me to them? The growing number of idle men. Or in their poses and glances, how difficult it is to distinguish them from displayed wares. Bread and Coca-Cola, brown nuts and water, biscuits and a car. When they lift pans above their shoulders, place kilograms of cement on their head, or shovel gravel, they know they do a job considered of low repute. For some of them, masonry and bricklaying is a temporary alleviation of unemployment. For others, there is no foreseeable alternative. And hence, they meet their fate with equanimity. Most Nigerians know that the standard food for laborers is a loaf of bread and a bottle of Coca-Cola. There are food stalls close to each house under construction, or in some cases, food hawkers who come daily. When these women bring food, when a man has taken a break from lifting building materials, there is an exchange of rumor, gossip, news, or experience.
Grown up close to water. He is on a boat in the middle of a lake. He sees neither east nor west, only water. He has never learned how it is possible to see pathways on a sheet of water.
One day at dinner, while Mancha Jawara was making One World in Relation, his film on Eduardo Glisson. The filmmaker turned to the philosopher and asked, "How can I simplify your ideas for a wider audience?" Glisson looked at him and smiled. "If I were you, I would wait until we were in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. Then point a camera at the mass of water, its abyssal expanse. And that would be the whole film in one shot."
The ocean is the world, without partition and division, only depth and expanse. Because of its depth, it serves as a burial place.
So if you point a camera at a mass of water, you get an opaque representation of gods and languages and objects and songs. Everything thrown in with bodies from the West African coast. The opacity of the sea is therefore its rich, dangerous promise. Some will drown, and some will make it to harbor. But his actual name, Gabriel, he tells me in a whisper, in confidence. When I tell him our mission, overland from Lagos to Sarajevo along the coast, he says, he's happy we aren't traveling through the desert. There are many burial places in the desert, he begins to aver. We find stones in the desert. We remove the stones and see a decaying corpse. The name on the document remains legible. This is how we recognize the person. In the desert, death means nothing.
Thank you.
Ajam returned from his travels, first West and North Africa, then South and West Europe. There was a world prior to my journeys, then a world after. He told me this. The people I have seen, the people whose stories I cannot forget, he said. Die trying to cross over. The young boys encamped behind a hill, possibly in Ceuta, waiting for the right time to make a run for the fence. Day after day, waiting. For some, year after year. Being driven to the border, Lejam asked the driver to stop close to the foot of the hill. About 25 boys encircled him, their number rising like water finding its level. Portraits of all the boys. There is also a list with their names, ages, and countries of origin. None of these documents have been shown to the public. Here's a possible list with gaps in place of all the present and future boys of that Ceuta encampment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
Ok, donc on va essayer ça. Là où je suis né, les tombes cachées des rebelles, des corps en centaines versés dans des fosses de vraies poubelles. Le cœur lassé des vieillards, ce l'est une éternelle haine qu'il transmettait sans peine aux adultes et aux gaillards. L'âme pourtant fragile des femmes, blessée par la lame de ces milieux de morts, ne trouvait désormais à la guerre de tort. Souvent dans les cours, les petits, comme s'ils approuvaient aussi que le sang coulant en mer, jouaient alors à la guerre.
Distance the
Enkedira, as I approached the border station 100 paces away, I stopped to catch the words of a man standing by himself, reclining on an electric pole. The street was busy, idlers mingling with passengers, hooting cars synchronous with bleating goats. The man's head was inclined downwards, and his voice was subdued as a whisper. But I had been walking so close, I heard him.
Today and tomorrow, God's time is the best.
Then we sat under a mimosa tree. The uncanny comes unrehearsed. I was making this trip because I chose to write a book about the Senegal River and its tributaries, and the lives of the people who lived along its banks. I wasn't courting a better life in Europe. His ragged backpack told the opposite. His travels were an imperative harsher than a choice. I had read only the epigraph before he stopped me.
Even a life full of holes, a life of nothing but waiting, is better than no life at all.
He spoke with his eyes shut. It was two-sided, crumpled and time-worn, advertising an exhibition of photographs. Two children in the picture were playing in front of an advert box in a port's transit area in Tangier. The ship in the picture was luminous with fluorescent light, harbored on a blue sea, or approaching anchorage, calm as a stone. Thank you. I am in Kadira waiting.
Waiting.
My friend was arrested.
Arrested.
We were standing in front of a train.
Train.
Took the photograph with my phone.
Phone.
Two policemen approached us.
Approached us.
They asked for identifying papers.
Papers.
I brought out my passport.
Passport.
My friend had none.
None.
When he was being taken away, he smiled at
smiled
me.
Smiled at me.
But his face contracted into many furrows, and he had opened his palms like a supplicant.
Supplicant.
I watched him retreating.
Retreating.
Half expecting he'd return to look back at me.
Look at me.
He didn't.
Didn't.
Now it was clear that our relationship was not one among equals.
Equals.
I have waited for his reappearance. I have dreamed of him reclining on an electric pole, reciting a chant. Today and tomorrow, God's time is the best. I have searched for him. I have been warned by policemen against circling the border station, peeking through cobweb shutters. Yet, without his name, I am told I cannot be given any information. In the dozens of hours we spent together, I didn't ask for his name. And he didn't ask for mine.
So on, it becomes
My dear Emmanuel, will you draw a dinghy for me? I was once told that parts of dinghies are named after good mermaids who befriend the sons of fishermen. Imagine your boat will carry a lot of passengers. It will be rowed slowly, wavering in the afternoon sea. Color it deep, dark brown. In the blue of the Mediterranean, against the white vastness of nothing from horizon to horizon. It will be noticeable by a rescue ship from afar. Now, you are a boat maker. Thank you. sentient, I spend a considerable amount of time observing trees. They are dense in the distance, sparse as I approach. Only when I'm close enough do I notice their singularities. And yet, because I do not recognize any of them, they remain anonymous to me. In the city where you and I lived, there were hardly any trees to serve as metaphor. Only now, I am away, do I realize that for you, I must become a tree. Every tree is the opposite of wandering.
Thank you. Shayla Tyler. Kazim Nakvi. Sophia Ray. Aubrey Johnson. Matt Mitchell. And my name is Sara Serpa. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank Roulette. I also want to acknowledge Ross Graham over there doing the lighting designer. Thank you very much. Yay. Thank you everyone here at Roulette for having us, for hosting us, and thanks for being here. Yeah. Thank you.
Sorry about that.